when nature unleashes its full fury, even the mightiest of human structures stand little chance. On the fateful evening of December 10th, 2021, the town of Mayfield, Kentucky bore witness to this harsh truth as a violent, long-tracked tornado tore through its heart, leaving a wake of unimaginable devastation in its path. This is the story of one of the most violent and destructive tornadoes to ever strike during the month of December, one that challenged our understanding of when tornadoes can occur and just how powerful they can be.
For now, this tornado has a history of producing significant damage.
The stage was set days in advance as a potent storm system began brewing over the central United States. Meteorologists monitored the conditions closely, growing increasingly concerned about the threat of severe thunderstorms and potential tornadoes. But little did they know, the atmosphere was conspiring to create a scenario of almost unimaginable destruction. On December 8th, the Storm Prediction Center outlined a slight risk of severe weather across the Mississippi Valley. However, there was uncertainty surrounding the degree of wind shear, instability, and timing of storms. The ingredients were present, but their true potency was yet to be revealed. As an intense upper-level trough plowed across the high plains on December 10th, the atmospheric conditions grew increasingly volatile. Warm, moist air surged, laden with instability and buoyancy. This tropical surge collided with a dry Arctic air, creating a violently unstable atmospheric battleground ripe for the development of supercell thunderstorms. The Storm Prediction Center recognized the increasing threat, upgrading the risk to enhanced and introducing a moderate risk area across the region. As if guided by some malevolent force, the atmosphere conspired to create the ideal conditions for a worst-case scenario, a multitude of intense supercell thunderstorms, each with the potential to spawn a devastating, long-lived tornado. It was a high-risk setup, one that would soon unleash a night of unprecedented fury upon the residents of western Kentucky. As the afternoon of December 10th unfolded, the escalating atmospheric tensions finally reached a tipping point. Like a shaken soda bottle, the skies burst open with the first explosive storms firing across central Arkansas around 2 p.m. local time. These were merely the opening act in what would become a night of unrelenting severe weather. Additional clusters of intense thunderstorms developed in the following hours. One particular supercell, which originated near Arkadelphia, Arkansas, soon intensified as it traversed an environment laden with extreme wind shear and instability. Radar data revealed the storm maintained a near-continuous high-end rotational signature, averaging 94 miles per hour for over 4 hours. This was no ordinary storm. This was a savage supercell, its tight cyclonic winds growing ever stronger with each passing minute. At 5:51 p.m., the first tornado warning was issued for portions of eastern Arkansas as the storm began exhibiting signs of rotation. Just under an hour later, at 6:40 p.m., storm spotters witnessed the unthinkable. A large tornado had descended from the supercell's underbelly. Immediate tornado emergencies were issued as the monster arced towards communities in its path. What had started as a seemingly routine storm system was rapidly devolving into a night of profound terror. There would be no stopping this monster. It had been loosed upon western Kentucky, and only devastation would mark its passing. The initial tornado touched down in Obion County, Tennessee, near the community of Woodland Mills at 8:54 p.m. local time. While this opening act caused only minor tree and roof damage, it was merely a harbinger of the devastation that was to come. Crossing into Kentucky's Fulton County, the tornado's winds rapidly intensified, reaching a low-end EF4 intensity as it tore through rural areas near Casey. Casey was savaged, its homes leveled, businesses destroyed, with some structures swept entirely clean from their foundations. The volunteer fire department building was obliterated, its heavy machinery tossed aside like toys. A music venue housed in an old school was badly mangled, its historic architecture no match for the tornado's ferocious winds. and in a tragic foreshadowing of the horror yet to come, one life was lost amidst the wreckage of Casey. With each passing mile, the tornado seemed to gather strength, feeding off the destruction it had wrought. Next, the monster then set its sights on Mayfield, a small city renowned for its charming downtown and historic architecture. At 9:26 p.m., the National Weather Service issued a dire tornado emergency for the city of Mayfield as the massive wedge tornado closed in from the southwest. Then, at approximately 9:30 p.m., all hell broke loose. A black funnel, wider than a city block, descended upon Mayfield streets. Trees instantly surrendered their limbs and leaves. Homes began exploding inward from the sheer force of the wind, and debris filled the air in a lethal, swirling maelstrom. With winds exceeding 188 miles per hour, just shy of the highest rating on the enhanced Fujita scale, the tornado tore through the heart of Mayfield with unspeakable violence. Entire neighborhoods vanished beneath the tornado's churning vortex, reduced to piles of lumber and crumpled metal in mere seconds. But the devastation reached its zenith in Mayfield's historic downtown district. Stately buildings constructed of sturdy brick and stone, some over a century old, proved to be no match for the tornado's relentless winds. The large and regal Graves County Courthouse, an iconic local landmark, was gutted from the inside out. Its roof and clock tower were torn away. Exterior walls collapsed, leaving the once proud structure a hollow shell. Nearby, the First Presbyterian Church, First Christian Church, and First United Methodist Church, architectural gems dating back generations, were largely leveled, their sanctuaries now piles of rubble. The destruction spared nothing and no one. The Mayfield Consumer Products Candle Factory, a large and sturdy industrial building where over 100 employees were working, was flattened in an instant. The metal-framed structure crumpled like a tin can under the force of the tornado's winds, trapping terrified workers beneath mounds of debris. In total, 8 innocent lives were lost within those ruined walls. Dual polarization radar imagery revealed the tornado's power. It lofted thousands of tons of debris over 30,000 feet into the air in a swirling, violent updraft. When the tornado's fury finally abated, the extent of the devastation was almost incomprehensible. 22 people had perished within the shredded remains of Mayfield, some never to be found. Hundreds more were injured, many critically. Entire city blocks had simply ceased to exist, replaced with apocalyptic wastelands of jumbled rubble and ruin. For the citizens of Mayfield, their lives had been ripped asunder in the span of a few horrific minutes. The place they called home was now an alien landscape of devastation. But the tornado's night of unprecedented destruction was far from over. Like an unstoppable monster driven by some primal, destructive force, the tornado carved its path of ruin across western Kentucky after departing the shattered husk of Mayfield. No community would be spared its terrible wrath. In the community of Cambridge Shores, situated along the tranquil shores of Kentucky Lake, the monster's whirlwind fury reached a terrifying peak. Vehicles were chewed apart and mangled beyond recognition, while trees were stripped of their bark and branches in weeping, denuded stands. The National Weather Service would later confirm that some of the larger, modern lake houses in Cambridge Shores were simply erased from existence by the tornado's winds. Their sturdy steel beams and robust construction were no match for this whirlwind's awe-inspiring power. A horrific repeat played out as the tempest skirted the northwestern outskirts of Benton. Yet the night's worst terrors were still to come, as the behemoth thundered towards the towns of Dawson Springs and Bremen. In Dawson Springs, entire city blocks were simply erased, their homes and businesses obliterated down to foundations sheared clean. The Dawson Village apartment complex was reduced to a pile of debris and shattered lives, its two-story brick buildings crumbling like sand castles beneath the tornado's footprint. 14 souls perished amidst the rubble. As if fueled by the sheer scale of the devastation it had already wrought, the tornado seemed to summon a final, terrifying burst of strength as it bore down on the small town of Bremen. A new tornado emergency blared as the monster crossed into Muhlenberg County, its black funnel an avatar of death and ruin. Bremen's residents could only look on in horror as the EF4 tornado, packing winds of 119 miles per hour, tore directly through the heart of their community. Homes were not just damaged, they were obliterated down to their very foundations, the structures themselves seemingly vaporized by the incredible force of the vortex. But nowhere was the tornado's violence more evident than along Bethlehem Cemetery Road. Here, a row of four homes was essentially erased from existence, reduced to scattered fields of debris with little more than shattered foundations to mark where they once stood. Bremen's house of worship fared no better. Bethlehem Baptist Church had one of its sturdy brick exterior walls blasted outward with explosive force, the structure bodily shifted off its foundation. Just down the road, the Church Street General Baptist Church lost most of its roof, the tornado's winds shearing away the chapel as if it were made of cardboard. When the tempest finally moved on, 11 more souls had tragically perished. But even as it continued northeast, the monster stubbornly refused to expend the last reserves of its strength. Near Hartford, it regained a terrifying intensity, demolishing homes and tossing semi-trucks in the air. Only after inflicting this final devastation did the cyclone at last begin to weaken and exhaust itself. It demolished a few final homes and barns before crossing into Grayson County and Breckinridge County, its furious winds falling to just a fraction of their earlier intensity. Then, after an almost unimaginable 165-mile trail of destruction, after departing a cross-state swath of devastation visible from satellite imagery, the merciless monster finally dissipated near Rough River Lake shortly before midnight, its fury finally spent. When the whirlwind finally subsided, it left a trail of unfathomable devastation. The tornado directly killed 57 people and resulted in 519 injuries. The catastrophic toll makes it the deadliest tornado ever recorded in the United States in the month of December, in addition to being the nation's deadliest tornado since 2011. Those 57 direct fatalities were inflicted across multiple locations along the tornado's extended 165-mile damage path. A staggering 24 people perished in Graves County alone, which also saw over 200 of the total injuries. Hopkins County suffered 15 deaths, Muhlenberg County 11, Caldwell County 4, with one fatality each in Fulton, Marshall, and Lyon counties. Tragically, a 58th victim suffered a heart attack while clearing debris, listed as an indirect fatality of the storm. The scale of the physical destruction was immense. Damage totals varied by source, but the tornado produced profound, catastrophic devastation in multiple communities. In Mayfield alone, over 4,000 structures were impacted, according to the National Weather Service. A staggering 3,778 residences, 183 commercial buildings, and 103 other structures damaged or destroyed. The tornado appeared to strike low-income rental housing particularly hard, leading to a depleted stock of affordable housing in the city. Nearly a year after the storm, the Mayfield Housing Authority reported over 700 requests for one-bedroom units, the limited availability laying bare the depth of the tornado's impact on the community's most vulnerable residents. In Marshall County, which contained the heavily damaged community of Cambridge Shores along Kentucky Lake, the devastation was no less profound. An alarming 356 structures were outright destroyed or rendered uninhabitable by the tornado's winds. A further 341 homes and buildings sustained light to moderate damage in the storm's wake. In a tragic aftermath, multiple lawsuits were filed against Mayfield Consumer Products, alleging that the factory refused to allow workers to evacuate as safety precautions, leading to the loss of life and injuries when the tornado struck. This massive and devastating tornado will forever be etched in the history of Western Kentucky, a sobering reminder of the raw power of Mother Nature. Let me know your thoughts on this event down in the comments. Do you have any experiences with tornado or other violent twisters of this magnitude? As always, if you enjoyed learning about this historic tornado, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to get notified about future uploads. Thanks for watching.